So a little bit of an update video on the FGC6 FA model, but it will also apply for the 6, and that is that you want to make the bolt really smooth, remove the layer lines. Of course the bolt is easy to do because it's external, so you can just use some, I did use also a knife and kind of scrape on the sides, because this is the contact points of the bolt that is sticking out, of course, and the top and the two on the sides. You want to make those smooth. What I used to do in the beginning was more use a knife and do it like this. That was still on this same bolt. But it is also good to use a fine sandpaper. Just give it a light sanding. You don't want to do it, of course, too much, otherwise you start to introduce too much wobble, let's say, inside of the upper. But with some wet sandpaper to kind of remove, and you cannot feel the layer lines on this one, so this makes it so you don't hear the layer lines noise, layer line rubbing against each other, making that really the typical noise that you normally would expect. Of course, for the inside of the upper, it would also be nice that you could do that. It was a little bit harder. I used to do it by hand and kind of do it a little bit, but I made a tool for it, and that's this one. It looks a lot like the bolt, but it's a little bit more narrow, and it got some way that you can clamp some sandpaper, a sheet of sandpaper inside of it, and then put this bar on top of it and bolt it down. One thing that you do have to keep in mind with it, if you tie this bar too tight, then the two sides here at the bottom will go wider, and then you will notice that you cannot insert it inside. Then you can insert it like this, that's a good check to do, but then this part gets too wide and you cannot insert it anymore. So it's smart to kind of put your fingers on there while you are bolting down, and it needs to be just enough that it grips on the paper, let's say. Also use a really fine, thin sandpaper, otherwise it's really hard to make a bolt that's the right thickness, that still fits inside of there. Also you don't want to take too much out of there, but in order, when you do it like this, and just take an, I will make a few sizes, but just take a bolt it in there so you have something on there. It isn't threaded rod, but if you use a long bolt and thread it in there, that's also fine. And that way you can just insert it. It's best when you do it without the barrel inside of it. The first one I did without, but this one I did not want to disassemble it all the way. So that will mean that you cannot reach it in the full length, but mostly that you can reach. And then it's just a matter of just moving this back and forward, of course. Do that a few times, and you will see that when the bolt is smooth and the upper is really smooth. You do hear sometimes that still that noise, but it's really a smooth action, and that will definitely help. Of course you need to make sure that all the other parts are aligned well, but you have to keep in mind, like, every little thing that makes friction in the system needs to be removed, because it's a really low pressure air system, and in order to make that move consistently and reliable, then you need to make it really smooth without going overboard, of course, and making it sanding too much so it's out of spec. With that said, the same goes for the spring. I used to use this spring because I had it on hand, but it's really tight around this rod, and because I needed the metal rod, I replaced it with an aluminium rod that was a little bit thicker, and then that one was giving a lot of friction on the spring. So all those type of things you need to make sure that that's alright. So use a wider diameter spring, then you don't have that issue anymore. There's one solution on sand down the rod. That's something that I did in this case, because it was aluminium. Quite easy to do. But that is something that you need to make sure that there is no a lot of friction and things going on like that with this platform. And that's not something that I did already mention. This bolt I will add it of course with the normals when it's released, because it's a thing you need to use to make this platform. So I will add it with the base package later on. Also a thing to note, when you insert it for the first time, or let's say when you insert it in the upper, that's a better way to put it. Kind of put your fingers on the side of the, let's say the sandpaper, just to make sure that it's not bending over, let's say let's did, but then the other way around, and kind of wrinkling away. So this way you know that it's inserted correctly and it's not flipping up, let's say. That's what I want to say. That way it will not fit anyways, but it also would, if it does, it will kind of give a really strange scratching mark on one side. That's not something that you want. This way you know it's all straight on there, and you're good to go. And then just move it fast around, but I'm not gonna do it on camera because it's a lot of noise, but you get the point when you do that. So how you apply the sandpaper on this bolt is just you fold it first inside of here, and one on the sides. Then you kind of make sure that the paper is aligned with the front of the bolt. You will wrap it around, in this case because it's already used. You kind of want to already kind of make a fold right there. Or you can do it later. I believe I did it later. Then you try to fold it, you hold it on one side, so you make it really tight on there. Pull it around. Then you fold this piece in there as well. At this point, when it's still on a roll of sandpaper, then you can see like where you can rip it off. So you have the correct length. And then just you fold it right in there. Then you start to really make those straight lines, so you know it's tight on there. Also the front need to be right like that. And then this is the point where you want to make sure that this is not going too wide. So you hold it right here, then you bolt it down, and just enough so it grips the sandpaper. You can see it could technically go a lot lower, but then it starts to pray away, and like that.